class of design of machine elements. I am Hitesh Rayani, assistant professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. This is lecture 23, Belt Drive. The learning outcomes of these lectures is to learn the introductions regarding the belt drive, selections of belt drives, and the types of belt which are used in belt drives. So this is the new chapters we have to consider in this chapter, design problems according to the different belt drives. So first we know what is belt drive. So introductions, what is belt drive? So as we know, as shown in figure here one belt drive is shown. In this there are two pulleys, one is the bigger pulley and second is smaller pulleys, and there are one belt is used which is connected between these two pulleys, and the power is transmitted from smaller pulley to bigger pulley. So smaller pulley is connected with motors, and the smaller pulley drives the bigger pulley. So as we know in these figures, we can say that the belt drive or any mechanisms shown in here is nothing but the power transmission system. So belt drive is used for the transmission of power from one pulley to another pulley, which is rotated at same speed or at different speed. So here the belt or ropes are used to transmit the power from one shaft to another shaft by means of pulleys which is rotated at same speed or different speed. So functions of or objectives of belt drive is to transmit the power from one shaft to the another shaft. Now let us know the amount of power transmitted depends on the following factors. So as we know that the belt drive systems is used for the power transmission from one shaft to another shaft. So which are the factors which are depends upon the amount of power transmission? So as shown in figure here the belt flat belt drive is shown. So according to the this power transmitted amount, there are four factors depends. First factor is the velocity of belt. So what is the velocity of belt? That is depends on the amount of power transmission. Second is the tension under which the belt is placed on the pulley. So how much the tension is generated on the belt when it is placed on the pulley. So this is the second factors which are depends on amount of power transmitted. Third is the arc of contact between belt and smaller pulley. So how much the belt is contact with the pulleys, that angle is also depends for the amount of power transmission. And fourth is the condition under which the belt is used. So whatever the condition at which the belt drive is used, that is depends on the power transmission. So these four factors you have to consider while you have to design the belt drive for the power transmissions. Now next is the selections of belt drive. Now you know that belt drive is used to transmit power from one shaft to another shaft, and for that belt is used. So you have to select the belt according to your requirement. So selections of belt drive, it depends on the following factors. First factor is the speed of driving and driven shaft. So it is the first factors, and second factor is the speed reduction ratio. So how much the speed is reduction from driven to driven, that is also one of the factor to select the belt drive. Third is power to be transmitted, how much the power is transmitted. So fourth is the center distance between two shafts. So how much the center distance between two pulleys or shaft of the pulley, it is also considered while we have to select the belt drive. Fifth is the shaft layout, which type of shaft layout is assembled That is also considered the one of the factors. Six is the space available, how much the space available for the particular drive, that is also considered by build, select the build type. And next and last is the service conditions. So these seven factors we have to consider while we have to select the build drive. Now next is the types of belt. Now we know the belt is used to transmit the power from one shaft to another shaft, and we know that to select the belt drive, the factors which is important. And now we go on the types of belt. So there are different types of belt is used to transmit the power or in belt drive. So first belt is the flat belt. So as shown in figure here, figure A shows the cross sections of flat belt, and you can see also the role of flat belts. So here the flat belt cross sections is shown by the pink hash. And if you see that this flat belt drive, the flat belt is used in mostly factories and workshops where the moderate amount of power is to be transmitted. So this belt is used in factories and workshops where the moderate amount of power is to be transmitted. And second consideration is when the center distance between two pulley is not more than 8 meters. So flat belt drive is used in factories and workshops, etc., where the center distance is less than 8 meters and the required the moderate amount of power is to be transmitted. So next belt is the V belt. So consider the figure V, which shows the cross sections of V belt and also shows the V belt drive systems. And here in figure B, belt, V belt is used and it is used in factories and workshops where the great amount of power is to be transmitted. So in previous flat belt drive, the moderate amount of power is to be transmitted, and here in V belt drive, the great amount of power is to be transmitted. So whenever the great amount of power is to be transmitted, you have to select the V belt drive. And also the considerations, the center distance between two pulleys. Here V belt drive is also used when the center distance between two pulleys is less than 8 meters. Now next is circular belt or rope. So circular, consider the figure C, which shows the circular belt. And here the circular belt as shown in figure C is used in factories and workshops where the great amount of power is to be transmitted, and the center distance between two pulleys is more than 8 meters. So it overcomes the previous V-belt conditions here. If center distance is more than 8 meters and you require the great amount of power to be transmitted, then you can select the circular belt. And if the distance is less than 8 meters and for great amount of power transmitted, you have to select the V-belt drive. So now the density of belt materials. So most of generally the material which used for the belt are shown in tables here are leather, canvas, rubber, balatas. This all are the mostly used material for the belt. So according to these materials, you can see the appropriate density of that materials. So this material density you have to keep in mind. Whenever it is not given in problems, you have to consider according to this table. So you can say that for leathers, the density of leather is 1000 kg per meter cubes. And if you see the balatas density is 1110 kg per meter cubes. So these tables you have to consider to select the density of particular belt material. Now next is the coefficient of frictions between belt and pulley. So now we know the belt, in belt drives, the belt is used to transmit the powers, and belt is connected with the pulley. So power is transmitted by means of pulley. So pulley and belt coefficient of frictions is important to calculate the power transmissions of particular system. So coefficient of frictions between belt and pulley is depends on the following factor. First factor is the material of belt, which type of material is used, that is depends for the coefficient of material. Second is the material of pulley. So material is pulley, material of pulley is also important. Third is the slip of belt, how much the slip occurs during the power transmissions. And fourth is the speed of belt. So this four factor is depends for the coefficient of frictions between belt and pulley. So if it is not given in problems, you have to select from the table shown here. In tables, you can see that first column shows the material of belt. So there are different belt material is shown, and according to these materials, and also there are second columns, there are pulley materials. So according to belt materials and pulley materials, you can select the coefficient of frictions for the given condition. For example, if belt material is rubber and the pulley material is dry cast iron, so for these conditions the coefficient of frictions you have to take 0.3. and for if you consider the Balata's belt and the pulley is wet dry cast iron, at that times the coefficient of frictions you have to take the 0.2. So in this way you can select the coefficient of frictions between belt and pulley whenever it is not given in problems. So in these lectures we learned belt drive and what is the conditions to select the belt and coefficient of frictions between pulley and belt. Thank you.